yourself servants to obey. The servants he are to whom he obey. Alright? Whether of sin unto death, of obedience unto righteousness. It says Romans chapter 6 verse 16.
Go ahead.
Know ye not that to whom ye yield yourselves servants to obey,
right,
servants ye are to whom ye obey.
Right, because if you love sin, you would be the servant of sin. That's what Yahweh said. If you love sin, if you love to keep going off lying, you know, hey, some brothers just lie for nothing.
God.
You understand? Some brothers just, like, no matter what they do, they can't tell the truth.
God.
You understand?
God.
Go ahead.
Of sin unto death, or of obedience unto righteousness.
God. Right?
So if you obey, you're unto what? Righteousness.
Right. God. Right? So Yahweh shall say, if you love me, keep my commandment. This commandment given to us. Right? Read the scriptures, Yahweh.
Yes. This is Romans 7 and 12.
Mm-hmm.
Wherefore the law is holy,
uh-huh,
and the commandment holy,
right,
and just and good.
And good. Yeah? Because when the law was given to us, it was life. Right? It's a lamp. It's to show us our way. Right? But Yahweh Shai now is our light. But he said, keep the law, statute, and commandment. Right? He said, listen, you don't have to kill a bullock or a sheep or a goat no more. I did that for you. Keep the simple law. The simple law. Right?
Somebody give him a job. Take the board off of us.
God.
Just keep simple law. Right? Why would he say, lest any one of you should break the least of these commandments? It would be, you would be the least, and teach others to do so, you would be the least in the kingdom of heaven. Why would Yahweh Shai say that? Why would the Savior say that? If we're not under the law, statutes, and commandments, of course we can't save by it, right? We don't want it, but it would keep us in line, it would keep us in the spirit. You know, it would keep us clean, because the law, as the brother just read, it didn't get no fault. It's just and it's holy.
Can.
Right? If you get Galatians 3, I think it was 2.
Galatians chapter 3 verse 2. Galatians 3 and 2. This is only what I learned of you. Receive ye the Spirit by the works of the law, or by the hearing of faith? Are ye so foolish, having begun in the Spirit, and ye now made perfect by the flesh? Right? I'll read it over a little slower, so we'll get it, right? Okay, to break it down. It says, my part, I'll read out.
It's verse 3.
Yeah, verse
319.
3 what?
Verse 319.
Chapter 3.
Chapter 319.
So, wherefore, then serveth the law. Alright, Galatians chapter 3 and 19. Wherefore then serveth the law? The question. It was added because of transgression. It was added because of transgression.
Yeah, the law was added because of transgression. Right? So, to keep us in line, to be holy because the law is holy. Yeah? I wish I say be holy for I am holy. Right? He said the works of the law would not only save you but also your faith. Right? That's why Paul said, come to the conclusion, keep in the spirit, bear the fruits of the spirit.
God.
Alright? Keep in the spirit, not the fruits of the flesh. Because the fruits of the flesh is destruction.
God.
And the fruit of the spirit is life.
God.
No?
Just after that, I'll jump back to verse 3.
God.
Verse 3 says, are you so foolish? Having begun in the spirit and now made perfect by the flesh.
Yeah.
That's what you're saying. Because yeah, we started off this journey as what? Spiritual men.
Yeah.
Doing spiritual work.
Yeah.
And through the spirit, recognizing that the spirit of the elders and the men of GMS.
Yeah.
The truth is in them.
Yeah.
But now, we become so righteous or over-righteous that we're saying that we are made perfect by what? The flesh.
Yeah.
Because the law was for the flesh.
God.
The law wasn't for the spirit.
God.
What was for the spirit? The faith in our Savior.
God.
Because we are saved by faith.
God.
Right? And it's faith in what? It's faith in Yahweh Shai.
God.
Yeah. Read the scripture.
Yeah, this is 2 John 1 and 6.
Go ahead, Ab.
And this is love, that we walk after his commandments.
Right.
This is the commandment, that as ye have heard from the beginning,
that
ye should walk in it.
Right, so we know the law, we know what we get from the beginning. The law is such a commandment. Right? And Yahweh shall fulfill the part of the sacrificial law, like I say, not again. it said that the Messiah will come. He did come. He came in the flesh. He dwelt among men. Right? And he ascended back to his Father. Somebody get Deuteronomy 10 and 12. Right? So it says, read back the scripture. You lost it? It says, wait, okay. It says, and this is love, that we walk after his commandment. His commandment. Right? This is the commandment that we have heard from the beginning. He should walk in it. Right? Read the scripture again, yeah?
Deuteronomy 10 verse 12. And now, Israel, what do the Lord thy power require of thee?
Go ahead.
What's it here? The Lord thy power.
What comes
to you? Think can you love me and I'll be broken if you walk out. But anytime you decide to pack up your things and leave, don't come
back. Where am I? Go back to scripture.
Deuteronomy 10 verse 12.
Go ahead.
And now Israel, what do the Lord thy power require?
Go ahead.
But to fear the Lord thy power.
To fear the Lord thy power. Go ahead.
To walk in all his ways.
Right. To walk in all his ways. Right. This is what it's saying. If you love me, keep my commandment. Right. And to walk in the way. The way the Most High. Go ahead.
See. And to serve the Lord thy power with all thy heart and with all thy soul. Right?
To keep. You miss a part there. To walk in all his way and to love him.
Again, Selassie. And
what?
To love him. And to serve the Lord thy power with all thy heart and with all thy soul.
Right. So, somebody give him Matthew 22 and 37. Because this is what is required of us, you know. And the men of GMS, this is what we do. This is what we do.
Matthew 22 and 37. Yahweh Shai said unto him, thou shalt love the Lord thy power.
Read up a little more.
Matthew 22 verse 35. Then one of them which was a lawyer asked him a question, tempting him and saying, Master, which is the great commandment in the law? Verse 37. Yahweh Shai said unto him, thou shalt love the Lord thy power with all thy heart.
With all thy heart.
With all thy soul.
All thy soul.
And with all thy mind.
Check this in. You tell, the Most High say, hey, love me. He's simply telling you, just don't break his law. Don't go off. Keep in the spirit. Keep his commandment. Right? Love his son. Believe every single word that he said. You understand? Go ahead, Ab.
It says, and verse 38, this is the first and great commandment.
So that is the first and great commandment, that you love the Most High with all thy heart, all thy soul, and all thy mind.
Verse 39. Right?
Go ahead.
And the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself.
Can't. Stop right here. Jump back to where you read it.
Okay, give you a quick one to add it.
Go ahead.
This is Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 13. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandments.
That's right.
For this is the whole duty of man.
Right, so that's what we're supposed to do. Fear the Most High. Right? Proverbs 1 and 7. Fear the Most High.
Keep his commandments.
And keep his commandment. You hear the scripture? Read the scripture.
Deuteronomy 10 verse 12.
You hear the scripture?
Proverbs 1 and 7.
Right.
This is Proverbs 1 and 7.
Go ahead.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge.
The beginning of knowledge. Go ahead.
But fools despise wisdom and instruction.
Correct. Right? Fools don't don't want to hear about truth. These fools don't want to hear about truth. They prefer you lie to them. Tell them Jesus is the name. Allah is the name.
That Christ came for everybody.
Christ came for everybody. And all the nation wouldn't be saved. Yeah, the scripture say in the Apocrypha, there's a double. You understand? And without a double, I mean, when you make the double, it make everything perfect. I just roughly, just paraphrasing it from the top of my head. You understand?
It says, Surah, chapter 32, 33, verse 14.
Go ahead,
Good is it against evil, life against death.
Go ahead.
So is the goodly against the sinner. So look upon the works of the Most High. And there are two and two.
Go
one
ahead.
Against another.
One against another.
Right?
That's not the double that they are. Alright, so that basically telling you that there's right and wrong, there's light and darkness. You understand? Scripture also says it can get sweet and bitter water from the same fountain. Everything is opposite. Everything. Right? Finish there? Get back to your scripture for me.
Deuteronomy 10 verse 12. And now Israel. What do the Lord God require of thee? But to fear the Lord thy God. To walk in all his ways. And to love him.
Right? To love him. Go ahead.
And to serve the Lord thy God. With all thy heart.
God.
And with all thy soul.
Go ahead.
To keep the commandments of the Lord and his statute, which I command thee.
Go ahead.
This day for thy good.
For what?
For thy good.
I said Friday. For thy good. For thy good. Right? Yeah, did you say?
Alright. But the thing about Israel, they don't like when you tell them about what they are doing wrong. They want to be rebellious, you know? They want smooth talk, you know? And the thing about the truth, they want you to polish it and cover it up. But that ain't gonna never happen. No matter how you try to do it, the truth would always be the truth.
Done.
And the truth does hurt.
Done. Yeah.
Right? And it does hurt internally. You know? There is the truth. You can't do nothing about sugarcoating the truth. Guess what? We out there doing the Most High work, fulfilling the commandments of the Most High. Right? Fulfilling the commandment of the Most High. We ain't out there with Michael Jackson. We ain't the next Michael Jackson about singing Food Criminal. We out there to bring truth, 100% truth from GMS, Great Man's Store. In no lie, 100% truth. The true doctrine. Alright?
True Holy Spirit. True the Holy Spirit that walk in true elders, apostles, and yeah.
Done.
Right, 3 and 9, right?
Done.
Right?
Done.
This is Jeremiah 23 and 9.
Read on.
Mine heart within me is broken because of the prophet. Done. All my bones shake. I am like a drunken man.
It's 29 now.
I think it's 23.
23 and 29. Yeah.
If not,
because like your brother say, some people want you to talk sweet words with them. You know about sweet words? The most, I see a 58 and one say, quietly.